Hey guys, so I'm doing a quick freestyle on this client. It's gonna basically be like glitter, white with purple, and some ombres, I believe. So as you can see, I'm just adding this glitter. I think I'm gonna make this into like a glitter ombre now, but I'm gonna put the glitter over the top instead of fading it out. Usually whenever I fade it out, I mean whenever I put the glitter over the top, I will do the ombre color first, so I'll do like a nude or whatever color I may be using first, and then I'll go back in and put the glitter on top of it and kind of fade the glitter the opposite way, if that makes sense. But I don't think I was really sure of what I was going to do yet. So I just went ahead and did like a fade with the glitter, with the ombre color. And then like once I kind of saw like the vision of what I wanted to do, I went ahead and I added the glitter back over the top. And you'll see me do that like right here. I think I'm gonna do it, yeah. So I'm just gonna add the glitter like right back on top and then just fade it down. Sometimes I'll like make my brush go the opposite way like that. And then sometimes I'll just scoot the glitter down. It really just depends. Whatever looks good is what I'll do. Like that. That's what I was talking about, scooting it down. So you can like barely see the ombre, like nude color. But you can obviously see it's still there. And there's a nude underneath the glitter. And this, now I'm gonna make it just a full glitter now. So I think I'm just gonna use 2 beads on this nail just to pack the glitter onto the nail, and then I'm going to encapsulate it, of course, with clear, and then really build the apex with the clear. I never really build an apex whenever it comes to glitter powders. I'll usually just encapsulate it and build the apex with the clear that I encapsulate it with. And I know some people put down a base of clear powder before they put their glitter powder down, but to me it doesn't really make a difference because the glitter already has clear powder inside of it. So, I mean, unless your client's coming in for a fill later, it doesn't really matter. Okay guys, so I'm getting a camera soon and I'm going to be recording more videos. This video was recorded on my phone, so all the videos you've seen from this video and before were on my phone. So hopefully whenever I get my camera, my videos will be so much better and I'll want to record more, because whenever I was doing it with my phone, it was so annoying to set it up because I had this annoying like thing that clamped onto my ring light and it would just make my ring light fall over, and it was just a pain. So hopefully the camera will make things so much better and I'll start uploading more. So on this pinky, we really wanted to add in some purple to it. And you can see me going with green, because we wanted to do green too, because it's in the glitter. But we kind of changed our minds because it didn't look as good as we thought it would. So you can see me go back in with purple and try to make, like, you know, like a cool, like, marbly sideways design. But you'll be able to see, like, on the thumb, it looked way better whenever I added it in while the white was still wet. Because on this one, like, obviously it's dry. And I had to, like, mix the color with my liquid. But whenever the white was still wet and I added on the thumb, you'll see it just mixes really well together. Okay, so this is what I was talking about. So after I add this, like, really wet bead of white, I'm gonna go back in and add a bead of purple and then just kind of mix it around while the white is still wet. And you can just see, like, as I move it around, it just mixes around really well and it looks like a good marble. Now I'm just gonna add more white and then add a little bit of purple right on top of that, and you can just see it just blends so well that way. Instead of just putting the white out and then letting it dry and or cure, whatever, and then adding the purple, it just looks so much better. And I'm gonna go back in and add some of the sparkles that I put on the index and the ring finger, just to give it a little bit more of a pop and make it stand out.